who coincidentally is the organist of the church where this organ originated in 1905. He was the present organist, and now he went to Valparaiso University this fall and is studying engineering, but his side passion is organ playing, and you'll see he's done very well already. And the piece is Prayer by Jean Langlais.
Thank you.
kit. He had all the notes on. I had to help with the pumper.
I was just going to say that one of the things about this instrument, the blower is a little bit undersized if you have everything on and you're holding a lot of notes down for a long time. So we were afraid that he was going to run out of air on there. So Devon got, there's a pump handle on the side, and you can actually run the whole organ without electricity and keep it going. But Devon was helping to keep the wind pressure up a little bit so it wouldn't run out of air.
They say the organ pumper's hymn is "Pump for the Wind is Fleeting."
My wife's going to get into music, so I think what we'll do is sort of the formal part of the dedication at this point. I just, with a project like this, as with pretty much any kind of project, there are lots and lots of people who are involved that make it happen. Some of us get to get some of the public recognition and glory for it, but it's certainly not a one-person job by any stretch of the imagination. And I would just like to thank some of the people who are here and who are not here that have helped to make this organ a reality here. First, I'd like to acknowledge Trinity Lutheran Church, and because it was their gift that allowed us to remove it from their chapel and bring it out here. And in your program, there's a mention about Gene and Virginia Pertz, who purchased the organ originally to move it from Church of the Annunciation in Aurora to Trinity Lutheran. And Virginia is here with us this afternoon. We're delighted that you're here. If you could stand and be recognized, we'd like to thank you. And I believe that there's some other representatives from Trinity Lutheran here also. This is her daughter, okay. And Hank and his wife are here also from Trinity Lutheran. We'd just like to thank you for making the trip all the way out here with us this afternoon. On the back of your program, it lists other people, and as I see some people, I will acknowledge them so that they can receive a little bit of recognition. Besides Devon and myself, Rich Sides, who is the custodian here at First Lutheran Church, was very helpful in doing a lot of little things that needed to be fixed or repaired or adjusted or tweaked to get to work, and his help was wonderful. Schneider Pipe Organs, when we got the organ here, there were a few broken parts to the action, and Devon put a posting on the internet pipe organ chat room, and within an hour we had three responses from around the country of people who said that they could provide replacement parts, which was amazing to me because I had no idea where we were going to get parts for something that's 100 years old. And the parts we were looking for are not things you can go and find the most. And we were able to find Schneider. Richard Schneider has an organ company down about 100 miles south of here in Illinois. And I sent him pictures over the internet of the parts we were looking for. And he said, "Oh yeah, I've got all of those." And so I sent him the broken parts, sent us the replacement parts. And so that was a critical thing, to be able to replace some of those broken parts. Jim Gruber was here on this past Thursday and helped us set the temperament on the organ and also deal with some wind pressure issues that we were having. McNamara Organ Services repaired one of the pipes that had a solder joint that came apart, so the pipe came in two pieces. We had to get it back in one. And Berghaus Organ Company helped with another pipe like that. Bob Schmidt's Body Shop got the dents out of some of our pipes for us. Johnson's Seated Canvas Shop re-leathered the tremulant unit, which we don't have hooked up yet for today, but if you want to see what it looks like, we'll be happy to show you, but you have to walk up here first. Carol Hedberg from the DeKalb Daily Chronicle did a wonderful article on the organ a couple of weeks ago, and if you don't get the Daily Chronicle, we have a copy of it posted on a bulletin board in the music room. It was a full-page color article, and just did a wonderful job of publicity for us and for the organ. The Jim Johnson, Gene Caleri, and Jan Womack were three of our strippers. Well, I knew some of you worked up when I said that. They helped, well, we had the organ all apart in pieces. They helped to strip the paint off it and to refinish it back to the natural organ that you see. And that was a big job, and I'm very appreciative to their help, for their help on that. Greg Kirkhorst, Bill Coleman, Daryl Henson, Mark McCaven, who you heard earlier, and Kermit Nordin were part of the movie crew when we drove into Evanston. And we met at 6 in the morning at Devon's house, and we drove into Evanston, and it took us most of the day to disassemble the organ and get it packed into a U-Haul truck. And we decided to leave Evanston when we were done about 4 o'clock, the same time as about 3 million other people trying to go home. And we made the trip back to DeKalb, and we had a dinner break, and then we came and unloaded it into the music room. So it was about a 14-hour day for those guys that were helping with that, and that was simply very important. Mark Hollingsworth is Devon and Carol's son, and he came on a number of occasions and helped with some work here. And then I put the many hands make light work movers for First Lutheran Church. There were a lot of things that Devon and I were able to do with just the two of us or one additional helper, but there were a couple of pieces that were extremely heavy that we needed a lot of people, and I unfortunately didn't write all the names down, but I put out requests on Sunday morning. We had a group of 12 guys that would come and help to move the wind chest so the whole keyboard action, and we couldn't put it together without that help. So those are the people who were directly responsible for helping to get the organ to the condition that it's in right now. And I'm just delighted with how it sounds and how it looks in this space. I think it's really turned out to be very nice. Nice little summer project. Maybe you were looking for something else, maybe you want to load some other organs that we really need. Lastly, I'd like to thank the members of the Worship, Music, and Fine Arts Committee here at the First Lutheran Church who have helped to provide the refreshments for this afternoon. So if you could join me, please, in thanking all of those people. Thank you.
Thank you.
was on the pipe organ encounter that I mentioned earlier last summer, and he's going to play a prelude on Old Hundredth by Austin Lovelace.
Thank you. Come up and try it.
I was driving with all the stops on.
Oh, yeah, that was just a single stop that he was using there.
Jim got a good workout, so anyone that hasn't done their aerobic workout that needs to have somebody sign out on it, we'll give him a chance.
If he wasn't talking, would you be able to play with the music?
Those of you that came a little bit later, Virginia, before you leave, this is Virginia. She's listed in your program. She and her husband donated funds to be able to purchase this organ when it moved from Annunciation Catholic Church in Aurora to Trinity Lutheran in the 70s. Moved to Trinity Lutheran in Evanston. And she and her husband did that in, as a memorial gift from the church, and she was able to make it here today, and I think that's wonderful.
Thank you,
man. Part of the feud, the first part of the feud.